Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. November 5th. So the day has come. Presidential election in the United States. I came across an article that I want to read you because, you know, I'm educating myself on those legal steps of the election and how the United States election looks like, what happens on the US election day and after that. This will be the title of the video, as well as this is the title of this article. Before I start with reading you this article that gives you a lot of information about how the process looks like, how they count those votes as far as who is elected, what is the election procedure, who votes, and what happens after the polls close, when the polls close, and how many votes does a presidential candidate need to win, and what is the role of the swing states. Very, very cool article. The last point is, when is the result officially announced? So, I'm gonna read you this. I hope you stay with me all the way to the end of the video. I have been watching the latest interview on Joe Rogan, who, by the way, endorsed Trump yesterday. And that interview was with Elon Musk. And I have to say that I was not a big fan of Musk for quite a long time. However, I discovered a side of him lately. I think he flipped from a dark side to the light side, because when he explains certain things that seem to be quite complicated, he does it in a very logical and simple way. The way he described and explained the situation with the illegal immigrants and how they are being used by the Democratic Party and put in the party that is in power in the United States at this point, right? We're talking the Biden administration and Kamala as well, how they have been used to be positioned in those swing states with the massive number of those illegal immigrants, and how that current government, that still is the government of the United States, wants to speed up the process of giving them the citizenship, meaning those will be the future voters for them. It's quite scary. And I do agree that this is the last chance. If you agree with this or not, as my channel, I can express my opinion. This is the last chance that you will not choose this complete evil side. You might think that the other side is evil. I tend to disagree, and I can have this opinion. Since it is my channel, I respect your opinion. I don't know if you understand that this matters, even though it might not matter for other countries, like to Russia, for example. Russia says it doesn't matter. However, I also disagree with this. You know why? Because depending on who wins, there will be a global war, or there won't be a global war. I am absolutely certain if they will let her, if they will place her in the position of power, because I'm sure she's not gonna win. She, if anything, she would be placed in that position. That means, without a shadow of the doubt, we're gonna have a global conflict on multiple sites, multiple locations at the same time. Europe, Middle East, Asia, you name it. And that for Russia means bigger conflict as well. I do believe when Trump gets in, those kind of conflicts will be avoided. You might call me naive, I don't think I am. And for all of us in Europe, it is important. And it might not be important for Russia overall. However, if there will be a global conflict, that will be also important for the citizens of Russia. because they will be drafted to a much bigger conflict unless they will go nuclear and then everyone just poof, you know. But the soul carries on. So this is my opinion. I'm sure some of you don't like it, and that's okay. I respect you guys. At the end of the day, we all have the same goal in mind. Peace, prosperity, decent, good life. Life where you can feel safe, productive, creative. You can enjoy your freedom. You can travel wherever you want, whenever you want. You don't require certain documents for that, as far as under your skin, certain objects, which I am absolutely certain if she's placed into the position. This is like the beginning, well, it's already started, of the Antichrist on steroids, whoever will officially be the one to take over this new world government. So guys, if you haven't voted, go and vote. I'm not telling you who you should vote for, but I think in your heart you know. If you turn off the TV and you just listen to your heart, it will tell you. Those who are in United States. So let me tell you what happens on the US election day and after that. Polls have opened in the United States. Voters will decide whether to send Kamala Harris or Donald Trump to the White House. Here is how the election takes place and the long process of the counting votes that follows. November 5th, today, is the election day in the United States, and voters will cast ballots not only to determine the future president, but also most members of Congress. The presidential race is tight between Democratic nominee Harris and Republican Trump. I don't think it's tight at all, but this is what is in this article. DW, this is the portal I got this article from, has the answer to the most important questions about the US electoral process. How does this process look like? Who votes? About 244 million people aged 18 years old and older are eligible to vote. Many formerly incarcerated people are excluded, so those who are in prisons are excluded from voting in some US states. Citizens, including military personnel living outside the United States, can cast absentee ballots to participate in the election. I believe that students as well, those who are Americans and study in other countries, they can also do this, absentee voting. Who is elected? Another part of this. The president and 469 members of Congress. The entirely of 435 seat House of Representatives and just over one third of the 100 member Senate will be elected. What is the election procedure? Voters can either cast their ballot by mail, by early voting, or by showing up at the polling stations on election day itself. Virginia kicked off early, voting on September 20th, followed by California, October 7th. By the way, can I just tell you here with California? So in California, they Newsom, you know, Gavin Newsom, Grusom, or how Trump calls him, Newscom. He announced a new law. He put a new law into existence that you are not allowed in those voting places to ask the voter for the ID. I mean, when you just think about it, how even this is possible? I don't know if this is not against the Constitution, but nevertheless, that's what they have in California. They have many, many strange things in California. So California, October 7th, Texas, October 21st, and Florida, October 26th. Throughout October, 47 states allow early voting. In some states, it was even possible to vote by post before that. North Carolina has accepted mail-in ballots since September 6th. Those are the tricky ones, those mail-in ballots. So when do polls close? While most polling places close between 7 p.m. and 8 p.m. local time, some, such as in Kentucky, close at 6 p.m., and others, such as in New York, stay open until 9 p.m. As the United States spans six time zones, by the time voting ends in Hawaii and Alaska, it is already midnight on the U.S. East Coast and initial projections have been announced. Yeah, they like to announce those very, very fast, right? They announce it and then they reverse it because they found something and they add to it and they add to it and they add to it. You know, I'm being sarcastic because 2020 was just... What happens after the polls close? As soon as the polling stations shut on election day, the votes are counted by poll workers in thousands of districts across the country. If the polling place uses paper ballots, each ballot box is sealed and delivered to a vote counting center. If digital voting machines are used, election officials send the voter data to counting centers. So they still use the same machines. I'm not gonna give the proper name of it because I don't want to trigger this platform. I will say domino, like Chinese domino machine. It has nothing to do with China. I'm just, you know, using domino. So they still use those machines, apparently, which is not good because they have been created in order to cheat. The rules for processing and counting vote by mail ballots vary from state to state. In 16 states and Washington DC, processing of absentee ballots is not allowed until election day. In 10 states, absentee ballots might be processed and counted before election day, but the results are not published until after the polls close. How many votes does a presidential candidate need to win? In the United States, a majority of the popular vote is not enough to win. Instead, the future head of state needs to have a majority in the Electoral College, or 270 of the 538 possible electoral votes. 270. If this number counts in deciding who will serve as a president and vice president, sorry, only this number is the deciding one. So 270 of the 538. For all but two of 50 states, majority voting system applies. Even if there is only a wafer thin majority for a candidate in nine states, the winner there receives all the state's electoral votes. One second. Therefore, a candidate could win more popular support than their opponent, but still lose. This has happened four times in the history of the United States, most recently in the Democrats' losses in 2000 and 2016, when Hillary Clinton had almost 3 million more votes than Trump in 2016, but Trump had the majority in the Electoral College. Next. What is the role of the swing states? So you, as you probably pay attention, the campaigning, the last campaigns and rallies that the candidates had was in those very important states. The swing states play a decisive role in the presidential elections. Swing states are US states that are neither firmly in the hands of Democrats nor the Republicans. So, you know, this is very good area to cheat. That's how I'm reading this. The key swing states this year are Arizona, Georgia, Michigan, Nevada, North Carolina, Pennsylvania, and Wisconsin. Next, what if no one wins on Electoral College majority? In the event that both presidential candidates are tied with 269 electoral votes each, it would be up to the House of Representatives to choose the winner. Now we see how this goes. Each state delegation would receive on vote and a majority, 26, would be required to win. This has not happened to date. Maybe this is what's going to happen this year, because God only knows what they are going to pull out from their tricks and shenanigans. Next, when is the result officially announced? This is interesting. In normal elections, right? In a head-to-head race, the announcement of the final official results might take some time. According to electoral law, any discrepancies in states might be resolved by December 11th. On December 17th, the electors will meet in their state capitals to formally cast their votes for president and vice president. On January 6, 2025, Congress will convene in Washington. Did I say this correctly? Convene, I think. In Washington to count the electoral votes and officially confirm the winner of the election. On January 20th, the inauguration ceremony for the president takes place in Washington, D.C. So this is how this process looks like, everyone. I would like to know what you think is gonna take place as far as how they're gonna announce it, because with this counting, especially the mail-in ballots, I think they cannot completely replicate the 2020, because it's a little bit different reality now. However, it's gonna take time, but as this says, by December 11th, right? On December 17th they meet, so those are the days. We will end this video with a comment of the day from Rhonda Murray, who leaves very often comments under my videos, and I thank you so much, I appreciate it. You said it yesterday, I am in North Carolina, voted early last Friday. There was a long line voting, not one person voted Kamala. Thank you for your comment, but I have to tell you, I just want to know, how do you know that no one has voted for her? Because you cannot ask physically every single person who was there. Maybe they just, you know, didn't want to tell you, because that would be probably the majority was voting Trump, and then it would be awkward. Who knows? Guys, with this being said, I just hope that we will not be dragged into a global conflict, because we shouldn't. There is nothing that justifies their decision, the evil decision, and I'm not being someone who is trying to tell you what to do. I just know that the reality with her is going to be completely different reality than it would be with him, even though some of you don't believe it. But trust me, it will be. Thank you so much for watching. If this brings you any value, this video brings you any value, even if you disagree with my opinion, if you agree, hit like. If you don't agree, whatever you choose to hit. Thank you for watching, for subscribing, if you still subscribe, and for following my channel and my videos. The link to the article I read you will be down below in the description box, and every other link to other platforms that you can find me on. I have Patreon, Locals, PayPal, Instagram, and every other place that you can follow me or support me if you choose to. Be safe, everyone. Don't be dragged into any unnecessary fights or discussions or arguments. Don't be triggered, because, you know, it's easy to be triggered when the emotions are high and so much is at stake. And with this being said, lots of love. And remember, we are the leading edge and we are saving humanity. It's getting colder. Bye, guys. See you in another video.